And it's recording.
It's recording.
You can see the counter. And the mics. Right, take two.
Take two. Second time lucky.
Leslie, we're chatting here today at the eLearning Network conference, and we were talking about leadership. And the participants in Velocity, we're looking with them at how you can be a leader from any position. We normally think of leaders as being the chief exec or the managing director, or we're sitting here the day after the American election. We might have other ideas about what being a leader means and how we recognise a leader. And although you've had a long and varied career, you recently were going to downsize your career and do retirement, but it's not retirement as we recognise it.
Retirement, but not as we know it.
And when we were talking, I think the example of what you're doing now with the charity Learn Appeal is a good example of being a leader in any position. Do you want to chat to me a little bit more about that?
Okay. When I took retirement, I was approached by the founder of the charity, Jonathan Satchell, and asked if I would work a couple of days for the charity. And he initially wanted me to be the chief exec, to have the status, to have the kudos, because I was going to be leading the charity, and it's effectively what I do on a daily basis. However, because I was self-employed, so therefore not technically employed by the charity, there could have been problems with being called chief exec. So I'm called the senior consultant, and to be quite honest, I don't actually mind what I'm called. I actually call myself the chief cook and bottle washer, because that tells what the job I do. And I think it's quite important to realise that leadership doesn't always come with the title. That very often, the people who lead the organisation are not necessarily the people who've got the title itself. You can lead from any position in the organisation. An awful lot of it has to do with, to be a leader would suggest that you need followers. And the way that you gain followers is through trust, respect, people having confidence in the decisions you make. And I think that can happen at any level in an organisation. You don't have to be the person who's at the top of the organisation to be the person that people go to. To be a leader.
And in effect, people elect you as a leader rather than you choosing to be a leader often, because they're choosing to follow you because they see something in you that inspires them or sets a good example or helps them progress.
Being at the eLearning Network is actually quite a good example of that. So the eLearning Network is a voluntary body, and the board on the eLearning Network is elected by the community. I used to serve on the board, and one of the things that you're asked to do is put forward your little manifesto, and then that goes out about the things that you can bring. So leadership isn't always about what you do to others, it's what you can bring along with you. And very often the skills that you bring can be from any level within the organisation. It doesn't have to be necessarily always coming from the top.
Yeah, and I think one of the first topics that we look at in Velocity is about your values, recognising, understanding, defining what your core values are. And actually I think that at the heart of every good leader, regardless of whatever position they're leading from, is some very strong values that people can easily identify in you.
Yeah, I would agree, absolutely. In most organisations I've been in, I've realised that it's actually important to listen to other people, to recognise that other people have contributions to make. And so I was not always sending emails. What I would do was I floor walked. So I would actually go and sit and spend time with people. If I had a question to ask them, I wouldn't email them and the rest of the world. I would actually go and ask. And that even applied with IT, that I got to know the people in the IT department very well. So much so that if there was problems with other people's IT, even in the area that I was in, the IT department, somebody from one of the IT support would say, is there really a problem, Leslie? Can you work out if there's a problem? Because we're really, really busy at the moment and you seem to have an understanding. And it was because they respected me.
Mm, they were looking to you.
They were
for
looking
guidance.
To me to get advice. And I think the same thing is no matter what level you're at the organisation, there'll be times where the people higher up the organisation, the leaders, will ask for people's opinions. And very often, if you lower down the organisation, there's maybe a lack of confidence that you don't feel that you're in a position to be able to do that. It's always worthwhile doing it. Or even if people don't ask, if you've had experiences yourself, because very often you might have experienced something maybe in your personal life or in another job that you've been in where there's been a similar situation. So good leaders will actually listen to what people have got to say, and people lower down the organisation can be leaders in their own right by offering advice, offering information, yeah. offering support. In terms of becoming a leader, there's many different ways you can do it. The charity sector is a very good example. So trustees in charities are very often appointed by the other trustees on the board. Sometimes there's even notifications that you can see in the charity press where they're asking for trustees to be part of it. There is a legal responsibility in being a trustee, but it means that you can, particularly if you've got a particular passion or interest in something, you can actually go and you can help and you can support, and the skills maybe that you learn from doing that, you might then be able to transfer into your working life, and vice versa, the skills from your working life, you may be able to put into supporting a charity by being a trustee on a board.
Yeah, brilliant advice. And it's so important to develop those leadership skills from whatever position you're in. And if you are looking to progress your career further within an organisation, you can't wait until you're appointed to a senior position to demonstrate leadership skills. These have to be visible within you before then for you to be able to attain that position.
Yeah, I would 100% agree, because very often when you go for interviews for leadership, it's a bit like chicken and egg. Mm. So they'll ask you what you've done to demonstrate the skills before they even appoint you to the job where they're wanting you to have these skills. Yeah. So it's you can go, you know, once you're in the role, you'll probably go on leadership training, but there's an awful lot you've probably done in your own life. You know, if you've been a wife and a working mother, for example, you've got plenty of leadership skills.
That's great, Leslie. Thank you very much for sharing your thoughts on that.
Okay, thank you then, Sarah.
Bye.
Bye-bye. I didn't know if you wanted the bit about the wife and the working mother.
Fine, yeah. No, I thought that was a kind of nice, light way to end up, you know?
But it's true, you've got all the blooming skills you've got.
Check it's playing.
See if it has it.
No, it has. It has it. 8 minutes.
That's right. Great. Oh, yeah.